Ladies and gentlemen, we've resolved the technical difficulties. We're ready to go. So please stand for the National Anthem of Wales. And now the National Anthem of Scotland.
Okay, welcome back to the Quad Skate Shop track here at the Men's Roller Derby World Championships. No, World Cup. I'm getting so confused
World
on
Cup.
The third
yes.
day.
All day of yeah. this three-day event. What an amazing 2 days we've had so far.
Absolutely. I'm here with the wonderful little Joker.
And I'm here with the lovely Panda. I love this lady.
For those of you that couldn't see, he was giving me a big hug then. It wasn't anything untoward, I promise. So we're going to be seeing Wales and Scotland facing off here. The first jam now underway.
And we have...
called off straight away by the officials.
I think they got a bit too carried away. I think Scotland and Wales...
They were so ready. And
so ready for this. And from what I can make out, we have... Cliff, the mechanic, on the track for Wales, and Nuke Jukem for Scotland. Nuke Jukem not to the outside, and he's going to be recycled back there.
He was having a lot of that to do yesterday, so he's going to be hoping to be staying on the track, looking for those lines down the middle.
And Cliff, the mechanic, getting out, picking up a lead jammer.
So it looks like Wales are going to be having the first points on the board. It's Judajam making his way to the penalty box for an out of play block.
Hayes recycling Nuke Dukem to the entrance of turn two there. Cliff the mechanic was knocked to the inside. Trying to fight his way through now. And he goes through for a 5 point pass grand slam.
Wales have now got Longworth, number 2 and 8, sitting in the penalty box as well. Okay, that's the end of the first jam. Let's do a quick rundown of the team roster. Scotland playing in the white jerseys today. We've got one, a lot of black and blue. 101, Matheson, 1664, Conenbig, 18, Tequila Jam, and 19, Judah Jam. 2212, Wyden McDye, 2D, Nuke Dukem, 67, I Horror, 8, Porky, AO2, Red Baron, number 9, WK Deed, 976, The Real Scrim Shady, 999, The Filth, and SR7210.
Do you want to run down the Welsh team?
And for Team Wales, we have number 1, Manwaring. Number 218, Longworth. Number 25, Truck Rogers. Number 254, Jones. Number 26, Swift. 2828, Ashton. 2x4, Renton Griffiths. Number 3, Hayes. Number 36, Phillips. Number 43, Clark. Number 79, The Mechanic. Number 9, Malatiniski. FE26, Meredith, and HK86, Clements.
So in that last jam, we saw the Real Scrim Shady coming through, had lead jam, pulled it off. Wales ahead with 6 points. Scotland yet to score.
So of course, both these teams managed to pick up points against Team USA.
Yesterday the game, Scotland-USA was phenomenal. It was a very exciting game.
So Tequila Jammer going through, ducks around the outside for a full 5 point pass grand slam. So Scotland finally on the board. Wales with just 2 blockers at the moment.
Scotland have got all their blockers on the track in the power jam situation. That is going to be helpful. And only 2 at the front that Tequila Jammer is having to contend with. Past Hayes at the front there, picking up another 5 points.
So 3-4 blocker advantage. Team Scotland still with the power jam. Tequila Jammer knocked to the outside and recycled only a little way back, just behind the jammer line.
Trying to fight for that outside line, but Wales absolutely exploiting the fact that they know he's going to go near him and they have the power at the front of the pack to block him to the outside of the track. And he calls it off. Penalty on the Welsh pivot. It's number 3, Hayes, on his way to the penalty box. So they're going to be skating the pivot short in the next jam. Wales, a really good team, but they so far have been harmed by the number of penalties that they've had, giving them the slight disadvantage. It was a multiplayer block on Hayes.
One thing I was noticing there with Tequila Jammer, he kept looking over at that penalty box while he was on this start straight, just to see whether the jammer's standing, wanting to call it off to give Scotland the power jam start.
Yeah, obviously jammer standing means they've got less than 10 seconds left on the penalty. So the Real Scrim Shady now taking a tumble on his way out, but he does pick up lead as taking a tumble at the front of the pack there. Jones picking up a penalty.
Yeah, Jones picking up a forearm. He's going to go to the penalty box. So Scotland still on the power jam. Real Scrims. Shady sneaking around the outside of Clements there out of turn two.
Jones not managing to make his way along the straightaway without the penalty, so he came back to the back of the pack from the penalty box. Didn't manage to make it through and then was sent on the way to the penalty box yet again.
Real Scrims. Shady forced to the inside there with a nice shove from Clements to the inside. He's back up, picking up some points and calling off that jam.
All right, so thank you for joining us today. You can see Team Wales playing in the red shirts and Team Scotland playing in the white shirts. Wales now on 7 points, Scotland in the lead with 18. Oh, sorry, that's just jumped up to 24. And the score's adjusted.
So even though Wales picked up the first points, they're definitely suffering already from penalties.
Yeah, I think we saw a lot of this yesterday as well. So they're going to be conscious of that. And I think Scotland are also...
also going to be wary of what's going on. They're going to try and force the penalties there.
Lovely foot there, footwork there from Tequila Jammer. I mean, this guy's a phenomenal little jammer. He's been having an amazing World Cup so far for Team Scotland.
Absolutely. He had a lot of got a lot of points on the board yesterday against Team USA.
And like I said, he's another one doing it for the little guys out there. Don't underestimate the little people.
Absolutely not. Some of the smaller jammers are the ones that can break through those holes, especially when you've got taller blockers on the track. Wales, three substantially taller guys at the front there. And trying to create that wall, but the jammer's really trying to get in through. Tequila's trying to get in with his shoulder to break up that wall.
Jones has just come back out of that penalty box on track. Tequila Gammon jumps on that inside, picks up those points. Jones going for a hit on Tequila Jammer.
It's quite a gap on the inside that he managed to nip through. I mean, jammer on jammer action now.
Yeah, I mean, Tequila Jammer knew he had lead. I was just like, you can play with me all you want, but I've got the power to call this off, so.
Yeah, psyching the jammer out. You see, we've seen quite a lot of this this jammer on jammer action where they've just been psyching them through the turns, keeping an eye on each other down the straightaways, and then the burst into the pack, and then pulling it off, trying to make the opposing jammer who's not lead fight and use up that bit of energy.
Yeah, so jamming now for Wales, we have Truck Rogers, and for Team Scotland, we have Nuke Dukem. Both jammers trying to get their way through. Chuck Rogers trying to take that inside line, forced to the outside, but unfortunately kept in by a Team Scotland blocker on the outside line.
Thought we were going to see an elbows penalty there, but it wasn't called.
Nuke Dukem trying to get through the Welsh four wall at the front up against Manwaring, last blocker there.
There you go. Comes through and fixing up. His elbow pads there. I think he had a bit of tussle with the Velcro.
And Truck Rogers getting out and picking up some points.
Oh, Wales going to be happy with that.
Yeah, finally getting their teeth back in the game.
Breaking into double figures. So Wales now with 11 points, Scotland ahead on 30. This still could go either way.
So we have 4-on-4 on track, empty penalty box.
And the penalty box brought to you by Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of roller derby kits and merch.
We have Wyatt McDye getting out there, getting lead jammer, and is now on a power jam.
Wyatt McDye, you can spot his wheels a mile off because he's got the lighter ones.
I know, he's probably not the best choice as a jammer, having flashy wheels.
Oh, goodness, yeah, he's going to be easy to spot if you're in the pack. All you don't got to do is keep your eyes on the ground and you'll know where he's at. Coming back around for another 5-point pickup if he can manage to make it through. Calls it off. Did he pass anybody in that last pass? Say 2-point pickup for the Scottish team. All right, if you're just tuning in, thanks very much for joining us down here on the Quad Skate Shop track at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. You're seeing Scotland in the white jerseys taking on Wales in the red.
I think that looks like the real scrim, Shady. For all the viewers out there, we're actually sitting on turn one, so we can't see the jammers until they come round to us. So. We're starting to learn them by face, but
you can't always see them, especially when they get pretty low behind those walls of blockers. Real scrim, Shady, now through, picking up lead for Scotland.
Scotland with the power jam, but a blocker disadvantage. Yeah. Wales with a full four on track.
Oh, Phillips and Clemens holding up that front line on the outside there, doing a stellar job. Is the jam pulled off? 2 points pick up there. The Scottish team. Pack didn't move very much in that last pass at all. I think he was feeling the fact that they're solid and I'm struggling to get through, so it's easier to call it.
I think we had WK Deed going to the penalty box for failure to reform.
Right. That was just as the whistle was called. I saw the arm go down from Major Travesty.
And we have, I can see Porky on track, and we have Tequila Jammer for Team Scotland.
Porky holding back.
I love the feistiness of Tequila Jammer.
He's relentless when he's jamming. Oh, but he was stuck. Wales come out and take the lead. Multiplayer block penalty called. And that is sending Longworth to the penalty box. Tequila Jammer now on the outside of the track. He's on his way out.
So Ashton is out there for Team Wales. And he is on a power jam, picking up some points.
So the track cut major sending Tequila Jammer to the penalty box. Leaving Wales in a position now where they can try and even up that score. Knocked to the inside by Porky the Penetrator. He doesn't hit light. If you're going to get hit by Porky, you're going to be somewhere on your
I've been on track against Porky, and I do my best to avoid hits from Porky.
As a result of that, he is sitting for a minute in the penalty box, though. I think he was a little bit egregious there.
I did see. Slowly clawing back at the lead.
All the action now in turn four as they're coming around pack, moving slowly, trying to make sure that they're holding. Ooh, it looks like the Scottish team were taking themselves down as they were going.
Tequila Jammer coming, powering out of penalty box. I don't think Ashton knows he's there at the minute. Oh!
The Welsh team definitely felt that. Powering into the back of them. We're having an official timeout.
Yeah, I think they're going to want to call.
Yeah, I think there's going to be something in there. It could be a back block, a low block maybe.
Well,
it looked like it went to the back of the knees.
It was a low block. He came flying into the pack, tried to stop, lost his grip and slid out underneath.
Right.
So I'm guessing they're going to have a discussion as to whether that's something a bit more serious.
Mm-hmm. All right, so just give you a little bit of an update as to where we're at with our sponsors. We want to say thank you to Fast Girl Skates. Their knowledgeable staff represents all facets of roller derby. That's WFTDA, USARS, MRDA, JRDA and Banktrack. They can relate and have what you need. The largest selection of skates and everyone, women, men, juniors, it's all about you.
And of course, Fast Girl Skates stock Green Monster Roller Sports products. They're all new. Go and visit them today at greenmonster.com. That's Green Monster without the vowels.
Yeah, GRNMNSTR.com. Okay, thanks for joining us here. We have an official timeout going on at the moment. Wales are on 36 points. Scotland ahead with just 4-point lead on 40. Wales playing in the red jerseys. Scotland playing in the white.
So we have Tequila Jammer going into that penalty box, the Roller Derby City penalty box.
Of course, we've got each of the tracks today here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup sponsored. The one that you're watching now is the Quad Skate Shop track, and the one at the other end of the hall is the Roller Derby City track, and each of the tracks then in turn sponsoring penalty box on the opposite track.
Yes.
If that made sense and wasn't too long-winded.
Of course, events like this couldn't go ahead without all the sponsors, the help from the sponsors. It's such a big financial thing to put on an event of this size.
Absolutely. And you guys at home watching as well, if you're liking what you see, you want to keep up the momentum of tournaments like this going forward in the future, please drop us a few pounds, dollars, any spare change you might have. Please check us out at mrdwc.com. Okay, so Wales now picking up lead with a lovely little pirouette at the front there from Meredith.
Yeah, beautiful. And Scotland down to just one blocker. And again, spinning around the outside of Judah Jam.
So a lot of black and blue now in the penalty box. The same wheels as White McDye, so he's another easy one to spot.
Porky now at the back with Judah Jam. Porky knocking Meredith to the inside. Judah Jam taking him all the way back there. And Meredith, Meredith's loving that little spinning maneuver.
That was a really easy line for him to take on the outside there, because his blockers were just holding that up. And obviously Scotland, the disadvantage of two, and just bouncing off of Porky there. Multiplayer block sending him to the penalty box. He's not happy about that. He's shaking his head. He wants to be careful he doesn't get an insubordination for not leaving the track, because he was aware that that penalty had been called.
And Keela Jammer coming out of the penalty box forces Meredith to call off the jam.
So we're going to be seeing both the jammers starting.
So now we're seeing Wales in the lead now. 56 to playing 40.
Had a lead change.
So a lead change. So we're seeing the teams with, obviously, with the players going in that penalty box are the ones that are, you know, losing control, and the other teams are taking full advantage at the minute.
Yeah. So we've got Nuke Jukem lining up for Team Scotland.
And it's the mechanic for Team Wales who gets out and gets up lead. Jammer, Nuke Jukem trying to fight his way through, finally breaks out. Oh no, picks up a forearms major. So Team Scotland suffering again, losing points on a power jam as the mechanic goes through for a 5-point pass out of turn two. Konenberg being held at the back, and the mechanic just drawing him to the outside. Team Wales blockers go in. Konenberg at the back of the pack.
He was really fighting up against Hayes there, not managing to break through that Wales wall. The Wales walls are really solid when they manage to pick up that outside line at the front of the pack. They're doing some real damage for the jammers. Mechanic now having to recycle behind a lot of black and blues now come out of the penalty
again
box.
We're seeing Konenberg with a lovely sweeping hit, but unfortunately he goes out of play.
There's a no pass, no penalty call there. Porky was signalling for a track cut, but it wasn't a track cut. Just didn't pick up the point for that pass.
Porky's back out on track, and Porky's a very heavy hitter. The mechanic, also known for being a heavy hitter as well.
Can you hear the crowd singing, Porky's gonna get you?
Porky's gone to the penalty box again for forearms. I think Porky's getting a little bit too het up on track. He needs to just try and calm himself down a little bit.
I think also he's struggling with a little bit of frustration with a knee injury, a recurring knee injury, which I think as of yesterday he was wondering whether he was going to be playing. We were wondering whether he was going to be in for the Team USA game, and he really didn't want to miss that up. He got it checked out by the medics, got it strapped up, and had the okay to continue playing. So, but I think he's going to be pretty tired and starting to get a little bit frustrated. We're going to be seeing that through his play.
I know Porky went on an absolute path of destruction in the USA game to help out one of his jammers. We have Truck Rogers forced to the outside by Judder Jam on turn one. Truck Rogers at the front of the pack trying to make his way through.
And he's through, managing to pick up lead. Filth out at the front there, trying to keep him down, but not managing to break that momentum as he bursts out of the front. Matheson now coming in for Team Scotland, jamming in the back, but struggling to get through.
I think Matheson, I think he was the first person. He was the first person to pick up points against USA.
All right, so
yesterday.
Team Scotland still sitting on 40 points. Wales ahead. Wales.
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 There's a Wales on track.
Ahead with 76 points. Let's see, we have just over 12 and a half minutes left on the period clock for this first period.
And the real scrim, Shady fighting his way through that inside line to get out, picking up lead jammer. Mechanic breaking the pack as well out of turn two. In comes Real Screen Shady. He's going to want to try and pick up some points. Heavy hit there from Porky, knocking the mechanic to the inside.
He went a huge distance off of his feet there.
The mechanic is a big bloke, and Porky is one of the few people that can sense on one of the mechanic's sides.
My goodness, two came out
lying
on the inside
like
on turn two and halfway down straight away. Goodness, what an incredible hit. He's going to be sore after that one. Some of the guys absorb the hits well, but I think from Porky, it's really tricky because he just powers through. I don't know how he does it. It's incredible. Very, very strong Scottish blockers.
Jones hopping around the outside, getting out, picking up lead jammer. And that is number 19. Shutter jam.
Breaking through that front. Past Kohlenberg on the outside, Judder jams it. Oh, trying to ride the outside line. A no pass, no point call there as he comes through Clements on the outside. Five more points on the board. Four more points, sorry, on the board for Team Wales as they get their fourth blocker back as Mannering comes back onto the track.
Jones being held to the outside by Luke Dukem, but then takes that inside line. Spicer's clear. And goes for that line.
Nuke Dukem taken down at the back there by Clements. Nuke Dukem sent off. Was that a back
block? That was a low block.
Low block.
The OPR was signalling for a low block on Nuke Dukem.
I missed that one. I'm glad you've got a pair of eyes as well. It's very helpful. Oh, he could have taken the inside line there quite easily, but he did full foul going into the back of the blockers. I think it made life a little bit more difficult for himself there, Jones.
So Jadajan being held off at the back there, trying to get through. I think Jadajan was signaling to his pivot, I want to do a star pass, but I don't think the pivot fully realized. Clements with a heavy hit to the outside, takes Jadajan to the floor. Doesn't send him out of bounds.
But he still manages to pick up 4 points in that pass to Scotland. Wales now breaking into triple figures. 104 points, Scotland's 48. Wales playing in the red jersey, Scotland playing in the white. We have a timeout has been called.
And the score's a pretty big difference now.
Yeah, we saw it was quite close initially, and then we had the lead change, Wales taking over, but they've kept that momentum up, moving forward.
And we're now, the scores are standing at 104 to 48.
We have just over 9.5 minutes left.
Just over 9.5 left on that period clock. That's going quick.
Yeah, it's really fast. Fast action on the track, and you kind of forget how long's left on the period clock. Before you know it, we're already halfway through. More so now. Just a quick shout out to Quad Skate Shop, sponsoring this track this morning and throughout the day. Europe's original brick and mortar roller derby equipment supplier, Quad Roller Skate Shop, is the best selection and most stock of any store on the continent, with excellent consultation services only a fellow skater could provide. We've got all your needs covered. We love this game.
Have you ever been to Quad Skate Shop?
I've not been there. I've met the guys that run it.
Yeah, they are lovely.
And they are super cool guys.
If you ever get a chance, you get to meet the shop dog. The shop dog's lovely.
I have to go.
He's a real flirt.
Oh. Okay, we have an official timeout being called now. We've just had a team timeout. Referees just looking at clarifying a couple of things. I think there wasn't any issue in that major championship, just making sure that everybody is okay, understands where they are, what they need to be doing. Which obviously everybody here, the non-skating officials, the referees, huge love to them. It's giving up their time this weekend. Everybody in roller derby is a volunteer, so.
And we have Whitey McDye jamming for Team Scotland.
Ihara taking a bit of a tumble to the back of the pack there.
Ashton getting out, picking up lead jammer. Whitey McDye breaking out as well.
Matheson trying to get Red Baron and Ihara to speed it up. You can see he was signalling with his finger in the air, spinning around in a circle. Not managing to really make any impact in that before it was pulled off.
But no points for either team means that the lead differential stays the same.
We'll see moving into the next 9 minutes. 9 minutes left in this period. We'll see if Scotland sort of move up towards the Welsh lead. could still go either way. These teams are actually really well matched. But again, like I said earlier on, Wales struggling a little bit because they've been penalty heavy so far.
And that was Meredith getting out, picking up Lee Jammer, the filth. Struggling at the front, up against the Welsh wall. Meredith going around the outside. Lovely footwork there, staying in bounds.
Oh, the crowd like that one.
Beautiful play there. And Meredith taking Phil down to the outside.
And himself. Oh, but we're going to be seeing Phil on his way to the penalty box.
So beautiful play there by Meredith.
A low block penalty sending the Phil.
Takes a hit, gives a hit to the Phil. Phil goes down. Out of control, takes down Meredith.
Yeah.
Power jam to Wales.
And that's one of the things in roller derby, you're taught when you learn to skate to fall small. Sometimes you just have so much momentum that you sprawl on the track.
Well, especially just then, it was obviously just Jammer on Jammer going full pelt.
Yeah.
And if you know what you're doing as a jammer, you can cause some damage to your opponent.
Yeah, absolutely. As you're coming through the turn, they're like pushing through the crossovers and really building up speed. And that's where the hits, in that respect as well, it was very effective. Team timeout now to Team Scotland. And we have just over 7 minutes left on the period clock. Wales sitting on 127 points, Scotland on 48.
I think Team Scotland are calling for an official review. I'm guessing they're going to be questioning that call, whether it was actually a low block or whether it was, you know, purely accidental.
Okay, so a little bit of a readjustment with the scores. I'm not sure if you can see this on your screens at home. Wales 120, Scotland 48, unless I just made a mistake. It's pretty difficult to see the scoreboard from where we're sitting.
120 to 48.
We've had the...
And we have 7 minutes 31 on the period clock.
Yep. And we just had a little bit of synchronization with the jam timer clock as well. A few seconds put back on. Make sure we're not missing any time in between when the penalty clock is stopped. Period clock is stopped for timeouts.
You can see our lovely jam timer for today standing on the pivot line, which is sponsored by GBEMS, the UK RDA's only accredited for... credit's not the word, is it? What's the word I'm looking for? Endorsed, that's the word I'm looking for.
Yep.
I knew it began with him.
These guys are really cool. They have their own derby names too.
I
think that's so cool.
And one of them, I think the one that's sitting opposite us with the ponytail, I think he refs Croydon.
I know he does know a lot of the skaters. I've seen him like dishing out hugs all around today, so I'm thinking he's going to be involved somewhere more than just...
I'm pretty sure he's one of the refs for Croydon. I could be wrong on that. Maybe someone out there can confirm whether one of the members of GBEMS is a referee as well.
Okay, so we've just had news from the Roller Derby City track. Half time. From Australia, Argentina, it's 151 to Australia, 149 to Argentina. That is a close game.
That is a very close game. I mean, I was standing watching some of that this morning before we started off this game, and those Argentinian guys are amazing.
I know, I think you have a little derby crush.
Yeah, I do. As we keep saying, though, they've come over with just 8 skaters.
I know.
The fact that they've caused such upsets.
They really have. I think people were looking at them thinking, 8 skaters, is this going to be
easy, you know, we'll wear them down. But they are phenomenal.
They've done an incredible job.
And LP Bay is an incredibly hard blocker to jammer to block.
Okay, we're just going to get ready to move on with the next jam. Timeout over. And it looks like the penalty call stands. Oh, blocking up at the front there. Solid wall is going to try and nip around the outside on Porky. But a multiplayer block penalty has been called, sending Porky to the penalty box. Porky and Eye Horror doing a cracking job at the front there. But it did look like there was a cross in the arms that was stopping the jammer from getting through.
Filth back out on track now, but Mechanic has got through, does have lead, and is picking up points for Team Wales. So he goes through for a grand slam. And the Filth trying desperately to get through.
He's struggling up against that inside line of Wales. An absolutely incredible job with the blocking at the front there. It's very, very slow moving. It almost looks like the pack is stopped at the front there, but they've got to be careful. They've got to make sure that they keep moving so they're not eligible for any stopped block penalties or clockwise block penalties. Ihor at the front of the pack there, and Judda Jam doing a great job. We don't just see him jamming, we see him blocking a lot as well.
Filth really, really struggling to get through this Welsh wall.
Okay, so we're seeing number 218 Longworth on his way to the penalty box, and he was just behind Ihor there. Now we've seen a star pass on the Scottish team, which sees Judda Jam donning the helmet cover for the Scottish team in white today. Coming through, breaking out of the front there. It's Matheson.
Yeah,
I do apologise.
Look, as we said, it is hard to see. They're on the opposite corner from us, and we can't see the names on the shirt. Madison knocked to the outside by Manwaring.
Arms up there at the front for...
And Porky, some heavy hits.
He's coming back in. He wants to make a difference on the track as soon as he steps on. It's all about the power. The power of Scotland for Porky.
The power of Scotland.
He is like the power personified in this. I mean, when he's in the defence at the front of the pack, those walls are just solid because the other blockers really use that energy, and they're kind of this influence that he has on the track. He's quite a formidable blocker.
He is a formidable blocker.
Okay.
We have Truck Rogers, and I think that's the real Scrim Shady.
Yep. So Scotland on 52.
Real
now out with lead jammer. Wales 143, but behind so far in this jam. Oh, but a penalty's been called.
Yeah, real Scrim Shady picking up a cut track.
So we... Oh, a cut track penalty sending...
Zero
to the penalty box.
Yep, zero against the penalty box. Truck Rogers on a power jam for Team Wales. You can see Truck Rogers trying to indicate where he wanted to clear everything.
Oh, cut track's going to send him to the penalty box. And they're going to see a switch in the box. So he's going to sit, and Scotland are going to have their jammer released. Oh, nearly taken down by his own blocker, entering the box there. The real Scrim Shady.
The real Scrim Shady up against a Welsh four wall. Swifty recycling back to the start of turn one.
These Wales walls power jams are immense. Up at the front of the pack.
What a cracking
job.
Seeing their recycling and reforming is so impressive this morning.
Holding that inside line and doing a great job. They've got one blocker facing forward, one blocker facing backwards, keeping an eye on what's going on with the real Scrim Shady. Just letting him do the work, pushing them forward, bridging out at the front so that they don't get the out of play call. They're moving out as far as they could for that.
We have Truck Rogers coming out of that penalty box and runs around that inside line.
No opposition on that line there. I think they're going to notice that he's coming down. They were too focused on the blocking.
Real Scrim Shady picking up a 4-point pass, and Truck Rogers matching that score. 3-on-3 in the pack. Wales with the back line. Here comes Red Baron.
He just exits the penalty box as the whistle goes.
So Scotland are going to be starting with a 4-3 blocker advantage.
I think we've got just 3 minutes left in this period. My goodness, that's flown.
I know.
What an exciting game between the two of the UK's teams, Scotland and Wales.
And the scores standing at 147 to Wales, 56 to Scotland. And Scotland were looking like they were going to take control to start with. And
yep.
Wales took a timeout and had a discussion. And it's clearly worked.
Wyatt McDye now jumping for the Scottish team, trying to break through the outside line, but being knocked to the outside. He's got to be careful that he comes back in and recycles towards the rear, because he'll be eligible for cut track penalties. He very nearly stepped in.
There was a lovely bit of awareness there by number 43, Clark from Wales. Tried to force the cut on him.
And it was no pass, no penalty through the turn two there, call from the outside.
Ashton calling off the jam, just takes a little casual look over to his bench coach. The bench coach tells him to call it off.
Okay, so looks like this could possibly be the last jam in this period. Wales 152, Scotland 56, Wales playing in the red jersey, Scotland playing in the white. If you're watching from home, thanks for joining us.
If you're loving what you're hearing, you can drop us a few pennies, can't they?
Yeah.
They can go on the board, there's a link on the broadcast website to make a donation.
Oh, that's Nuke Jukem through for lead jammer for Team Scotland. Jones struggling at the back of the pack, still not being able to break past that wall of coming up against Red Baron and Tequila at the back there.
Nuke Jukem trying to make his way around now.
Wales managing to break up the wall at the front there so that Jones could get through. No points in that one, and three or four on the board for Scotland. 4 points signaled by Megalomaniac from the inside. So where are we at so far with England, Argentina, Australia? It's 184 to Australia, 159 to Argentina, and we are well into period two on that track.
Now we have White and McDye up against the mechanic, 4-4 on track, empty penalty box. Both jammers trying to force their way through. Both jammers going on the outside line. White McDye gets out, picks up the lead. Jammer mechanic recycled.
There's a nice little jump over his teammate's legs coming through. In low block, Major sending Matheson to the penalty box. This, the last jam of the first period in this Wales against Scotland.
White and McDye trying to make through to pick up some points. Mechanic just holding his shoulder there. Hope that doesn't affect the rest of the game.
So Hayes on his way to the penalty box for a forearms penalty, so he's going to be starting the next period from the penalty box, and that is half time. So the teams are going to take a little break. We're going to take a little break and go to some adverts, and we'll be back soon.
Yeah, come back, ladies and gentlemen, home. And if you're just joining us, I'm Lil Joker.
And I'm Pandemonium.
And we are back on the Scotland-Wales game. Scotland had a good start, but Wales turned the tables on them and now winning 152 to 64.
Wales got a few really strong power jams in and just ran with the lead.
Yeah, White and McDye jamming for Scotland.
Meredith jamming for Team Wales in the red.
Picking up the lead.
White McDye struggling through that back line now. He tends to go for those outside lines, but he's blocked to the outside an awful lot as well. So he's going to be looking to, hopefully moving forward, he's going to be looking for breaking the inside of the pack, trying to take the inside line. But he's sitting in the penalty box now for a track cut.
I think that was forced by Griffiths, I think. Meredith coming around for a scoring pass up against two Scottish blockers. Making his way through, takes a little tumble into turn three. One Scottish blocker forces him to the outside. That was Cronenberg. Cronenberg being a very, very strong blocker for the Power of Scotland.
Absolutely. We have WKD and Matheson now back on the track, followed by Hayes from the penalty box. Hayes in red for the Wales team. Meredith now just coasting his way around, keeping an eye on what's going on the in the pack, trying to find some holes, really have a good look at where he can break through, managing to take it through, juking very nicely through the inside to the outside, picking up another 5-point pass. Mike McDye now coming back onto the track.
Yeah, Meredith just taking a nice casual look back at his bench coach there.
That's why he likes the outside lines. But unfortunately, it's not working to his advantage very much so far today.
Yeah, Wyatt McDye does love hop, skipping and jumping down that outside line.
I think Wales are well aware of that, and they're holding those outside lines really well. That first pass in that last jam was very strong for the Wolves, for Wales up at the front.
We have a 3-4 blocker advantage for Team Wales. Mechanic on the jammer line for Wales, and I think that is the real scrim. Shady.
Oh, taking a tumble there at the back.
Oh, lovely spinning manoeuvre there by the mechanic around the outside of turn one to get out. Pick up lead jammer, and the real scrim. Shady spinning around the inside at the engine of 10-3 to break that initial pass.
Mechanic trying to speed up his pack by the looks of things, signalling to his jammers, no pack situation called as the jam is called off.
I think that was 3 points. Yep, 3 points being held up by the Team Wales jam ref. That looks like Jones on the jammer line for Wales and Duke Newcomb for the Power of Scotland. 3-on-3. Both teams with a player in the Roller Derby City penalty box.
Both with the advantage of having the pivots on the track. So
Jones getting out, picking up that lead jammer. Mook Dukem trying to get through. Takes that inside line. But Jones on a scoring pass, powering around the outside. Porky coming in with a hit. Doesn't make contact. So 4 more points on the board for Wales. Scores are 178-64 to Wales. 26 minutes on the period clock.
Okay, so lineup ready for the next jam.
We have Matheson for the Power of Scotland. Scotland with 4 blockers, blocker advantage. And that is Ashton. For Wales, lovely footwork from Ashton there.
Round the outside on his toe stops, but very, very close to the rope on the boundary.
That was beautiful awareness there.
Absolutely incredible.
He was looking over his shoulder at that outside line.
I think he has done an absolutely incredible job today. Ashton has been a standout jammer for me for Wales to this point. He's not necessarily been fielded as much as some of the others, but when he has, he's actually we're seeing more of him now in this game.
Yeah, I mean, yesterday in the exhibition game, I got to play against, play alongside him.
Yeah.
And the rest of Team Wales were saying they wanted to put some more jammers in for that.
Yeah.
Just to see how they do.
Oh, Whiteman's eye down on the outside, but he's through.
First lead jam we've seen for Scotland in a while. Truck Rogers for Wales finally breaks that inside.
Wyatt McDye doing what he does best, juking beautifully around the skaters there. Knocked to the inside, calling it off just before Truck Rogers manages to put any points on the board. That's the kind of play we get to see from Wyatt McDye ordinarily. When the pack is doing what he wants them to do and they're spreading and making holes for him, when he can find a gap for his feet, his footwork is beautiful. And you can follow that quite easily because his wheels are really obvious on the track.
Yeah. So we've got a 4-2 blocker advantage to the Power of Scotland. Real scrim. Shady on that jammer line up against the mechanic. Mechanic trying to fight through that Scottish four-wall. Real scrim. Shady trying to make his way through, just getting caught up within his own blockers, taking an outside line, gets out, picks up a lead jammer. Mechanic stuck in the pack. Red Baron with a challenge there.
So we're going to see somebody making their way to the penalty box. I'm not sure who that was called on. It was a forearms penalty on the jammer.
I did.
That was called in the last pass from the outside. So
yeah, I did see Travis calling, like trying to send him off. The message didn't quite get relayed to the jam ref. But it's understandable because I can hear the crowd from the Australia-Argentina game.
What a game that's turning out to be so far. We're just going to get some scores updates for you. And as we are with the Scotland-Wales game, Wales ahead, 179 playing in red, Scotland 73 playing in white. Now with Nuke Jukum, lead jammer for Scotland, and a power jam for Scotland. They have the advantage of having all of their blockers on the track right now.
Nuke Jukum up against a two-all and for the Jones. Jones trying to force him to the outs. Sorry, that's Man Waring.
He's out of play, so he needs to cease contact. Wales now having their pivot rejoining us. Phillips. Argentina 233, Australia 215 on the other track at the moment. Oh, Nuke Jukum. Cut track major calls from the outside. Double entendre sending him to the penalty box. So a switch up now. But Wales have their jammer standing. So the mechanic is going to be released. And I think he's pretty much served his minute. I'm not sure if we're just actually seeing a swap there. Yeah, he was released just as Nuke Jukum settled down.
The mechanic trying to fight his way through power of Scotland. Holding him off. Phil.
Cracking job from Matheson and the Phil there up at the front.
Yeah.
Trying to recycle back. Wales denying them to get back towards the rear of the pack.
Again, Matheson and the Phil. And mechanic just hanging. That was his initial pass, and no points have been picked up.
So we're seeing this jam running for the full 2 minutes to reach its natural conclusion. Wales now through, picking up another 5 points, extending that lead. A clockwise block penalty. That's sending Wales number 9. That's Malatinski.
Hawkey being held at the back. And the crowd's going.
Matheson riling him up there. Drums and the chants going. Scotland, I think, bought the noisiest of the fans today. They definitely have been winning the crowds over. And they're basically jeering everybody up and getting them all involved. So the Men's Roller Derby Association would like to wish all the teams competing in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck this weekend. The MRDA is the international governing body for the Men's Track Flat Track Roller Derby and wants you to join them in the growing world of Men's Roller Derby. For more information about joining and the benefits of being part of the MRDA, visit them at mensrollerderbyassociation.com or send inquiries to info@mensrollerderbyassociation.com. We have a team timeout now. Looks like that's been called by Team Wales. They're having a huddle over by the bench just to regroup, looking at strategies for moving forward and keeping hold of that lead. Now 109 points ahead on 189 to Scotland's 80.
On the jam line, we are going to see Ashton lining up against Wyatt McDye. 4-3 blocker advantage in the favour of Power of Scotland.
I'm really impressed with the work that Ashton's been doing here today. And it'll be interesting to see how he fares up against Wyatt McDye. Wyatt McDye tends to find that if the pack conditions are right for him, he can get through the pack really well.
He's a nippy, jukey little jammer, so if there are gaps, he can get through. It's when he comes up against strong, tight walls that he struggles to get, like, to penetrate those walls.
Exactly.
He looks for the disorder in a team's defense.
He doesn't necessarily come in and go for the shoulder. He's trying to find the gaps more than anything rather than wedging himself through. But that's exactly what he's doing right now.
Yeah,
Zippy heard me.
Yeah. It's the moment you say that, he tries to wedge himself in. The thing, Hayes picking up a high block major. White and McDye still on that initial pass, but takes that outside line. So he sees the gaps. Now he's up against the just two blockers. Weaves his way through. But Ashton on a scoring pass now for Wales.
Has the lead jammer advantage. Calls it up as White mid-eye. Reaches the back of the pack. 2 points on the board for Wales in that last pass.
And we have Meredith on the jam line for Team Wales up against Real Scrim Shady.
Team Wales playing in the red jerseys. Team Scotland playing in the white. Thank you very much for joining us here on the Quad Skate Shop track. Next jam underway.
Real Scrim Shady trying to take that outside line. Meredith pushing through. Is he going to break through? Just Tequila Jammer out the front, out of turn one, gets out, picks up lead jammer. Real Scrim Shady taking it out of turn two on the inside. Both jammers completing the initial pass, but Team Wales with the lead advantage.
Griffiths looks like he's holding his hands up there to say it wasn't me. He's on his way to the penalty box. It'll look like an out-of-play block. Or some kind of contact in the pack that sent him to the penalty box.
No, that was one of the Welsh blockers picking up a back block.
Ah, back block. That'll be them. That'll be Creek Griffiths' back block then.
So Nuke Cucumb up against the Mechanic, 4-2. Advantage to Power of Scotland. Power of Scotland trying to cinch in the Mechanic to the inside line. Nuke Cucumb taking the outside line. Heavy hit there, bouncing off
there
the outside. Heavy shoulder hit there, but Nuke Cucumb straight back up to get out and pick up lead jammer.
Malatinsky did a good job, but only for a couple of seconds. Couldn't keep him down. He was getting very far into the engagement zone, very close to the edge there.
So Power of Scotland coming back now, picking up some more points. Wales still with a hefty lead, 194 plays 88.
Just over 17 and a half minutes left in this period. White McDye lining up on the jammer line for Team Scotland, who are playing in white.
And Jones for Team Wales in red. Power of Scotland still with a 4-2 blocker advantage. Jones, a very, very strong, powerful jammer. White on McDye trying to make his way through. Which one's going to get through? That was neck and neck. Tequila Jammer trying to hold off Jones, but White on McDye pips him to the post and gets out to get that lead jam status. And he's accelerating away from Jones. White on
Pack's moving really, really quickly now as well.
Well, White on McDye likes the speed. Ducks around the outside, pops up on his knees.
Zero was really integral there to White McDye's lead. He made that hole at the very front of the pack for him and holding back the Welsh jammer, and that's what made the difference. So that was a really good play from Zero at the front of the pack there for the Power of Scotland.
I could see Meredith calling for a skating out of bounds for White or McDye towards the end of that. I think he thought he'd taken himself off track. I think there was an initial contact and he just popped himself off. But we're back underway and Nuke Cucumb through, picking up lead jammer.
Ashton now recycled towards the back of the pack behind Red Baron.
Red Baron holding him off at the back of the pack. Now Red Baron recycling past the Wales wall. Now coming in for an assist on Nuke Cucumb.
Nice footwork from Ashton, managing to stay in bounds. Coming through, not lead jammer, but he's broken out there. Pulled off, not managing to pick up any points from there. Scotland putting another 4 points on the board. That's going to bring them past 90, so 92 to Wales, 195. It is 103 points between the two at the moment.
Your maths is far better than mine. 15 minutes remaining on the period. Clocks are halfway through the second period of this game. Judder Jam, Tequila Jammer, and I can't see which other blocker Power of Scotland have. They have a 3-4 disadvantage now.
It looks like Zero up at the front.
Meredith knocked to the outside, being recycled back to the by the power of Scotland. Real Scrim Shady coming up a strong, coming up against a strong Welsh four wall.
Ooh.
Both these jammers struggling.
Staying inbounds there from a hit from Judah Jam.
And Real Scrim Shady now trying to break through. In comes Meredith, popped to the outside by Judderdam, who's taking him all the way back.
He's got to keep an eye on where he, how far back he's recycling, because once he's out of play, then it's not, there's no point in being there anymore. An out of play penalty calls on Phillips.
Yeah.
Pivot for the Welsh team on his way to the penalty box.
He'd recycled Real Scrim Shady, didn't see the out of play called by the referee on the inside, continued to positionally block him.
They have the warning there from the referees. If they're out too far and they don't take notice of that, if they're not aware, the penalty may ensue. Four more points on the board for Team Wales.
I can see the bench coach for the Power of Scotland going into the centre there. She obviously wants to have a word with some, with the head referee about something she's seen on track.
Yeah, I think that that was possibly from the out of play block call, which it was stretched across turn two, which is right in front of where we're sitting. It looked like they were trying to bridge as much as they could, but the call stands because the pack broke up too far behind.
And she has to stay in the centre of the track because Jam is under the way as Waiton McDye goes to the inside, gets out, picks up Lee Jammer. And he is on a power jam now for the Power of Scotland.
Oh, very nicely done out of the front of the pack there, picking up 5 points.
He's got three blockers, Madison, Porky and Cronenberg. Some heavy hitters. Ducking his way through. Oh, lovely little maneuver spinning round the final Welsh blocker out of turn two. Some phenomenal footwork coming out of Waiton McDye. He's determined to pick up some points.
He's really showing them what he can do now. Struggling again with the walls up at the front. Power jam is really strong for him. But he did cut the track at the front of the pack.
I think he was hoping that they were out of play at the front and he could do that. But I think he didn't quite get the judging right on the distance. Came back in, took the risk, and unfortunately it was the wrong risk to take. And he's now in the penalty box, and the mechanic is up against Cronenberg at the front. I keep saying Cronenberg, it's Cronenberg.
So we have some news from the Roller Derby City track. Team Australia 252, Argentina 238. It was almost looking like Argentina were going to take that. What a turnaround at the about there. So Australia just a handful of points ahead.
Yeah, I
that's
think
the final score.
I think out of all the teams that have played at the World Cup, Argentina is going to pick up the most, I don't know, what's the word, progressed, impressive, Dark Horse Award.
the underdogs.
Yeah.
They came and took it. They've been really impressive this weekend as well.
And skating with 8 skaters and doing as well as they've done.
All right, we're having an official review in place now, but we want to let you know that you can look us up on Instagram under MRDWC. Share your photos of yourself enjoying the cup wherever you are. You never know, they might make it onto the stream, so you can keep a track of what's going on Instagram, MRDWC. And you can also find us on Twitter. Use the hashtag,
yes, MRDWC. Use the hashtag. Do not use the @ MRDWC, because that is someone else.
That's not going to reach us, so make sure. Don't forget, here today, the final day of the Men's Roller Derby World Cup, we are playing for the Spirit of Derby Cup this afternoon. Have you seen the trophy?
Yeah,
it is a thing of beauty.
It is impressive, and I've heard that the little skater on top is actually modelled after Rex Tangle.
Ah, his name is Apex Rex.
Yes.
Ah.
Yeah.
All right, and there's some really cool pictures of that actually on the Instagram feed. They
got him to do some apex jumps and some jumping around on track and took some pictures of him to get it modeled on him. And he has such a beautiful style. I absolutely love watching Rex Angle on track because he doesn't seem to weigh anything.
He just floats.
Yeah, he's one of those skaters that just hovers around on track.
Alrighty, so also mention, if you haven't checked out Fast Girl Skates already, please do so. Fast Girl Skates offers unparalleled expertise, customer service, fast and economical shipping. Visit us at www.fastgirlskates.com for league and military discounts. And you can also skate with Blue Streak from Fast Girl Skates. They're designers of the Blue Streak boot with unparalleled comfort, fit, style and performance.
And of course, with Fast Girl Skates, they also stock Green Monster roller sports products. Green Monster all new this year with an amazing range of new colours on their antique boots. They also sell, they're also the manufacturers of moto bearings, gumball stoppers, reckless wheels, yep. Heartless wheels, berserk wheels.
We have Quadzilla here this weekend. He's representing the Team USA. They've got a lot of the antique boots in all of the Team USA colours. I really like those. That's a nice touch.
So really nice. Really nice boots.
So don't forget, we have a full day of roller derby today, the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. We're glad to have you join us. Don't forget that if you are listening online, if you could drop us a few pounds, dollars, whatever the currency is in your area, using the link on the broadcast page, this money is split 50-50 between us and the team's travel funds. So in the world of roller derby, we don't get paid for what we do unless you guys help us out to get here and to provide these services for you. So if you're enjoying watching the feed, we absolutely love you guys. Thank you so much for joining us. If you're able to drop us a few some donations, it is very, very much appreciated. Some of these teams have come from so far on the world today. I think the Australian team have they travelled so far even just for their team tryouts.
Yeah, I heard that there was a
coast to coast, pretty much.
Yeah, it was a massive distance for the tryouts for Team Australia.
So it's been really, really incredible getting to meet all the teams here this weekend and all of the officials and working with the announcers. You guys, it's been an absolute privilege to work with you, Joker.
Finally getting to work with you, Panda.
Our lovely producer, Bob Knox, is sitting next to me. He's an absolute pleasure to work with.
We love Bob.
And he's just sitting there grinning now. He knows it. Okay, so having an official timeout, just sorting out a few things on the inside of the track. I can't believe the Argentina Australia game was. I was watching that in the half time on the feed, and oh my goodness, it was so close. At one point, Argentina were in the lead with 206 points, and Australia had 201, and it was looking really, really close. But that ended with an Australia win.
I think we had the Scottish bench coach in front of us using our table to write some numbers on a shirt. And I just noticed that...
The reason why.
Yeah, the reason why. We had a lovely gentleman from GB EMS seeing to one of the Scottish players on the inside. I think it's only something minor. He may have got a slight hit to the face, but I think he's going to have to change his shirt, because if he's got any blood on his shirt, yep, he won't be allowed to be on track unless he changes his top.
Yeah, so they were cleaning the inside of the track there. I've seen a few skaters have had a couple of buffed lips this weekend as well, and that's been quite an issue with bleeding.
So,
Wales... Jones out in front with lead jammer now. Multiplayer block sending Jodajam, who's a pivot for the Scottish team, on the way to the penalty box. Wyatt McDye now back on the track from the penalty box.
Wyatt McDye up against a very strong four wall at the back of the pack in turn one. Wyatt McDye trying to find his way through.
This is what he finds hard, especially when they're blocking. They get him on the outside every time. Whenever the walls are solid, he goes for that outside line, and they know it's going to break him and get him off the track.
I mean, Wyatt McDye's only a wee blocker, a wee jammer. And when he comes up against solid walls, he does struggle.
But now it's a power jam for Wyatt McDye.
So Meredith is just dominating Wyatt McDye at the back of that pack, keeping him on turn one.
Struggling to get through. He's up against just one blocker there at the back. Meredith.
Oh, spinning around. See, this is where Wyatt McDye excels. When the pack gets split up, he can find those gaps and just jump, hop, skip, and weave around the blockers. When he comes up against these solid walls, he really does struggle. But what he needs to see is his team breaking up those walls and splitting them up.
Creighton Griffiths now making him recycle back as Judah Jam comes back on. That's going to be a help for White Medai if he can make some walls in the pack. Through on the inside, skating backwards.
Oh,
it was a cut track penalty though.
Trying for that fancy footwork, didn't quite get it. Got a bit of a contact from one of the Wales blockers, sends him to the inside, rolls back on track, and picks up that cut track, putting him back in the penalty box and releasing Jones back out now.
It looks like White Medai was only probably half a wheel's width on the inside of the track. It was very much looked like he was trying to ride that line, wasn't successful. So
I did hear from someone that in one of the games yesterday, White Medai managed to do a shooting the duck out of the pack to pick up Lee Jammer. He took a hit, he was right on the edge on the outside, ducked down, was on one leg, put his leg out in front, rode the outside line all the way around, got out, picked up Lee.
Oh
now,
my
that's
goodness.
That's impressive. And with his snazzy shiny light up wheels, it must have been an awesome sight.
Impressive.
Well, we're seeing Truck Rogers on a power jam for Team Wales.
Scotland have got all their blockers on the track, so they're going to be making hard work of it for him. Porky there bridging, but picking up a penalty. I think that's his sixth.
Yeah,
if that's
Porky,
his seventh, he's going to be fouling out.
Yeah, Porky was on five penalties.
Yeah, coming into this period, yeah.
Second period. So Truck Rogers has lead. He'll have got 1 point for Tequila. 2 points for passing Tequila Jammer at the back.
Taking a tumble at the front there. Face down, facing the pack.
White McDye coming back out of the penalty box. But Truck Rogers pulls off that jam.
So we're going to be starting the next jam with
two jammers.
Short on the Scottish team. But both the jammers on the track for this one.
Then we have Meredith up against Nuke Jukin.
Wales on 211, Wales playing in the red. Scotland on 108, so they've broken into triple figures now. And they are playing in white. And just over 8 minutes left on the PV clock.
I mean, there was a time where it did look like that Scotland weren't going to be picking up any more points or struggling to pick it up, but they have, like you say, they have crawled back into triple figures. And Nuke Jukin trying to make his way through, hops around the inside of Clements to clear that pack, but Meredith spinning around, taking a hit in turn three, pulls off the jam.
Very nice pass around Judah Jam. But down on his knees in turn three there, pulling it off. Good use of the advantage there of Lee Jammer. Now, if you think you're not going to see any way forward with it, and you've got your other jammer pretty close by, it's easier to use that to your advantage.
Now we're seeing Tequila Jammer back on the jammer line for Power of Scotland. We haven't seen much in that first period.
No, he's been blocking an awful lot.
I know they had a very tough game yesterday against Team USA.
Oh,
so
they did.
I think... Oh, lovely footwork by Tequila Jammer.
Oh.
Heavy hit there.
Didn't manage
by Hayes.
To down.
Sends him to the outside.
Recycling the mechanic now.
So bow jammer's being recycled. Tequila jammer, lovely footwork. Keeps in bounds, gets out, picks up lead jammer.
Team Scotland now picking up the pace of the pack, but making the jammers work hard for it. Stopping now in turn. Oh, goodness. Meredith almost taking a tumble out there.
Hey, look, picked up. Oh, he picked up all 4 points. Sorry. Oh, 3 points.
Okay, so Scotland, one of the jammers, one of the blockers. Sorry, the anthems are being played on the other track. It's a little bit hard to hear. Three blockers on track apiece.
Luke Jukem up against Jones. Jones trying to take that outside line there, now pushing to the inside. Duke Jukem, oh, neck and neck. Both jammers going out of bounds.
Luke Jukem did pick up the lead for that, but it was in no pass, no penalty. Call there for Cherry Fury. Gorgeous hand signals.
She does have really good hand
signals. She is amazing.
It's the wrist movement. Yeah. That she has with the flicking.
So Matheson now with his newly created shirt.
Yeah.
Number 101 in the white.
One of their Power of Scotland merch shirts.
It's quite lucky that they have them, really. The bench staff come around. Has anybody got a sharpie?
Scotland taking to the pivot line. Mm-hmm. Pivot line sponsored by GB EMS, who were there to serve Matheson to help him get back on track.
Yeah, the only UKRDA endorsed medical team. So glad to have them on side.
Ashton getting out, picking up lead jammer. And White and McDye trying to get through, but being dominated, recycled by Hayes, taking him all the way back to the start of turn two.
It looks like he's tiring a little bit. I mean, and taking a breather before he starts. Or maybe he's just...
Oh, my God.
What a beautiful jump there around the outside.
Oh, that was
one heck of a...
He did a 180 turn, then hopped backwards. Staying in bounds. It's just a shame that Wales pulled the jam so he couldn't continue.
That's the kind of showmanship that Weimar Dye really soaks up. The when the crowd are loving it, he really gets into a good stride with it.
So Tequila Jammer on the jam line up against Meredith.
Three blockers apiece in the pack for each team now.
Tequila Jammer taking that outside line power from Tequila Jammer.
Easy, not too much opposition there.
Meredith
trying to focus too much the Welsh team on getting their own jammer through.
Meredith coming up against a strong Scottish wall. Tequila Jammer knocked to the inside. Man wearing recycling. Tequila Jammer back. Meredith out of the pack. And Tequila Jammer pulling it off.
Did he get the full four in that one? Yes, he did. 4 points. Scotland now inching slowly forward on the points. Where are we at with that? Wales on 220, Scotland on 114. Just over 3 minutes left in this period. My goodness, time has flown this morning. Next jammer about to start.
We have the mechanic up against Real Scrim Shady. Real Scrim Shady up against a Welsh three wall.
High block major sending Porky the penetrator to the penalty box. That's his seventh. Oh, what a cheeky guy.
That is definitely Porky's seventh penalty. He's going to be ejected.
He was giving the crowd a little bit of a show there on his way across. Mechanic coming through on the outside, not picking up anything. He was hoping for that, but I think he was almost on his way out of bounds at that point. Porky now fouled out, so he's being asked to exit the track.
So, timeout being called for Team Wales.
I'm not sure if it's going to hinder Team Scotland too much that Porky's out now, because we've seen a lot of the blocking that's going on within the team is really solid. Regardless of whether he's there, I said earlier on, he is a formidable force on the track. But
he does bring a lot of energy with him.
Yeah. So we'll see if that makes a difference.
We've got 2 minutes left. We're going to get one, maybe two jams, if we're lucky, out of this before this game is over.
The Scottish team are going to put all their energy into...
just trying to get just a few more points on that board. Just try and close down that differential just that little bit more.
I fancy they're going to try and break the 120 mark, so that then we can say it was a 100-point differential.
Yeah, if they can take control and keep that differential to just 100 points, they'll be very pleased with that result. Jones is going to be stepping up on the jam line up against Nuke Jukem.
Referee's in position, waiting for the final 5-second call.
Power of Scotland, one blocker down, as we've seen Porky has been removed. And I can't quite see which blocker is in there in his place in the penalty box. The Roller Derby City penalty box.
Yep. It looks like it's Red Baron.
Yes, that is Red Baron. So Jones and Nuke Jukem trying to find his way through. Welsh four ball holding tight. Jones getting through, gets out, picks up lead. Jammers of Wales with control in this jam. Nuke Jukem being pummeled by the Wales blockers,
recycled
back into the start of turn two. Nuke Jukem trying, looking for an assist from Madison. Nuke Jukem finds that inside line.
Breaking through as Jones calls it off right behind him. No points on the ball for Scotland in that last jam. 5 on the board for Wales with a natural grand slam on the track.
So we're going to have another jam. 1:08 on the period clock. 2:30 to 1:14 to Team Wales. Truck Rogers on the jam line. And that is the real scrim. Is that the real scrim shady, or is that Tequila Jammer? I can't see. That's Tequila Jammer. Tequila Jammer powering around the outside. Lovely, lovely maneuver there by Tequila Jammer.
What a great bit of jamming there.
That was phenomenal. Taking the tiniest little line around the outside. And Tequila Jammer hopping through on the inside, followed closely by Truck Rogers. Truck Rogers trying to eye him up. Messing around with each other. Truck Rogers crashing into the Power of Scotland, being forced to the outside.
And he's going to let this jam run as much as he can so that they can try and break through and pick up those points. Ooh, turning his ankle over on the outside there.
Hayes pushing into the outside. I think Power of Scotland just going to try and get as many points on this as possible.
Ooh,
going down courtesy of his own player, unfortunately.
Over a lot of black and blue.
Truck Rogers going to the outside.
In no pack situation, called Tequila Jammer could have entered much earlier than that, and through the turn he left quite a gap between him and Clark at the back there. And he's coming out now. Long with signalling Truck Rogers on the back of the pack. No point, no pass, so 3 points in that last pass to Tequila Jammer.
Truck Rogers got sent flying across the inside of the apex of turn three. And that was courtesy of Red Baron.
Red Baron we've seen with some really strong blocking skills today. I've been really impressed with the way that he's been playing. Holding up those back lines very strong.
And Tequila Jammer picking up a cut track at the end.
Between Wales and Scotland. Wales in the red jersey, Scotland in the white. The final score will feed back to you in just a moment when we can see the scoreboard.
The unofficial was Wales finishing on 2.45. And 1-2-3 for Scotland. 1-2-3. So that's the unofficial. 1-2-3 to 2-4-5. But that was such a fast game. I mean, it was over near enough as soon as it started.
Yeah, it was. I think up until the first half of the first period, we saw a Scottish lead.
Yeah, Scottish looking very strong, looking like they were going to take control. Then Wales regrouped and just dominated. And yeah, coming into the second period, just dominated.
They really held the walls absolutely solid and relentless for the Scottish jammers, who had a pretty hard time of it in the second period.
Yeah, and one thing I am loving at this World Cup is these lovely extra long bridges that the crowds are doing for the skaters to go through at the end of their games.
A lot of love for the guys in this tournament, the men's Roller Derby World Cup. Don't forget to follow us at #MRDWC on Twitter and MRDWC on Instagram. Send us your selfies. You might make it onto the feed.
And there go the winners, Wales, taking their victory lap.
Somebody on Twitter, Kat has tweeted us saying, if I died tweeting #MRDWC, it would be an epic epitaph. That's us ready to go to adverts. I am Pandemonium.
And I've been Little Joker.
Thank you very much.